Good evening, everyone. We're going to start next session. We'll call Dr. Wasila Taha to present IVUS in iliac vein, how useful it is.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And one more time, thank you for the kind invitation, Professor Hisham Sharafeddin and Professor Tariq Radwan. Good afternoon, everyone. And thank you, Professor Hisham Sharafeddin, for the kind invitation. My topic here about the IVUS. IVUS in iliac vein stenting and how useful is it? I have no disclosure. IVUS is the intravascular ultrasound. It allows to see from inside the blood vessels. It's the internal eye for the vascular surgeons. The probe here is of high frequency. It could be between 20 or 40 megahertz. And the catheter is attached to the probe, and the catheter is attached to a computerized equipment. There is a lot of indications for the IVUS in peripheral vascular disease, but here we are just focused and highlighted its role, its a crucial role, in fact, for the iliac vein stenting. We have two big contexts, the non-thrombotic iliac vein lesion and the most famous condition in the May-Turner syndrome, where the left common iliac vein is compressed by the right common iliac artery, again the spine. And this is where first described by May and Turner in 1957, and it occurs predominantly in young women between 20 to 40 years old. And the next scenario is the occlusive venous disease, the proximal occlusion. And this is really a devastating condition, a post-thrombotic limb. Here the patients suffer from heaviness, edema, venous claudications, and in good part, in good quota of our patients suffer from venous ulcerations. And this is the crucial role for imaging to differentiate between the primary and secondary pathology. Yes, reflux count, but also the proximal obstruction is very important to detect. And if you are an operator for duplex ultrasound, you have to go above the inguinal ligament and to think obstruction. There is a lot, a long list of modalities, the MR venography, CT venography, and the duplex, and of course, our core here today, the IVUS. This is the MR venography showing the left iliac vein occlusion. And this is a CT venography showing a very interesting, beautifully detected May-Turner syndrome, where the left common iliac vein compressed by the right common iliac artery. And this is by duplex here, proximal left common iliac vein compressed by the right common iliac artery. And very interesting, even the collaterals around the tight stenosis is depicted by duplex. This is a chronic iliac vein occlusion here. The left common iliac vein is a thread-like, very minimal color flow. Even if you ask the patient to go provocative test or maneuvers like Valsalva, even you try to go for low velocity scale, it's still a thread-like flow and also in presence of collaterals. So if you don't have such quality, high quality of duplex, and you need really a predictor for iliac vein obstruction, this is when we raise the red flag. On the femoral vein itself, and you can compare with the contralateral femoral vein, if you have a ribbon-like flow and loss of phasicity or modulation of respiratory phasicity, this is a very good and strong predictor that you have an ipsilateral significant stenosis or ipsilateral iliac vein occlusion. So if you have such long list of modalities, why we do IVUS? In fact, the answer comes with Dr. Raju. In third, half cases can be missed by conventional venography, while the IVUS is very sensitive to depicted such lesions. And this is a systematic review and meta-analysis, and as we know, this is the highest level of evidence. Dr. Raju in this meta-analysis and Peter Neglin also showed the superiority of IVUS imaging over the venography for the diagnosis of iliac vein occlusions, and also IVUS, it's a very precise and precious guidance essential for the proper stent placement. Video trial, it's by Paul Gagne. This is the principal investigator of this trial. It was conducted in 11 centers in USA and 3 centers in Europe. 100 patients were enrolled in this trial, and venography was succeeded only for 51 out of 100 patients, while the IVUS was succeeded to identify each one out of 100 patients with a statistically significant p-value. I would like to share with you two cases with two different scenarios, one of non-thrombotic and the other with thrombotic occlusive disease. And the first case was a 28 female patient and left lower limb with heaviness. Duplex was done by one of our senior registrars, show proximal left common iliac being compressed and with a small caliber. CT venography was really failed to depict this focal stenotic lesion, and we repeated our duplex by a senior consultant in our team, confirming the previous duplex finding. This, there was a stenotic lesion with 2.5. We recommend for IVF, and here we are the venography of this patient, and look to the here the video of the IVUS, and when the right common iliac artery traverses and crosses the vein, it's really stenotic and can really show the stenotic lesion. This is when we are the IVC, pullback of the here, the presence of the right, and very attenuated and stenotic left common iliac vein. And this is the correlation between what we have in IVUS, the stenotic lesion of the proximal left common iliac artery, and the corkscrew appearance by venography. This is very interesting slide. This is the axial cuts of the IVUS. The yellow arrows here point to the tight lesions and the tight stenotic lesions in different levels, while the blue ones point to the proximal healthy segment and the proximal distal segment. So what we have like information from this slide, we have all informations we need to put a stent in the iliac vein. Number one, it confirmed the diagnosis. It confirmed, yes, there is a stenotic lesion at the proximal end of the left common iliac vein. And number two, the healthy from the healthy. As all we know, to deploy a stent in the iliac vein, we have to go from healthy segment to a healthy segment. So by pullback of the catheter, which is graduated and there is a measurement, so by pullback, you can, from healthy to healthy, you can know the length of the stent we will select it based on the measurements by the IVUS. And one more time, the native diameter also from the healthy segment, Bardo, also measured by the IVUS. And this is after deployment of the stent. And this is the completion venography with a free flow up to the IVC. And this is a duplex follow-up, her first follow-up by duplex, by B mode. The duplex deployed with the right common iliac artery, you can be very well seen. And this is by color flow, a very well deployed patent stent. The second case, it's a thrombotic or occlusive disease. A female patient, 47 years, heaviness, edema both lower limb. Advanced clinical manifestation, she had the right side, it's more symptomatic than the left side, with restless leg and crippling venous claudication. Again, high quality duplex was performed, and again, we found the proximal iliac vein occlusive disease. And here, we decided to do for venography and stenting the right side. This is the left iliac axis, in fact, which well corresponded to what we have as a duplex information. We have a very thread-like flow with large collaterals. IVC in this patient was spared, was patent. And this is the right iliac axis, and she was much more symptomatic on this side, and very corresponding, very correlating what we have on duplex. We have a double channel flow, and we have a big collaterals on the right side. Prior stenting, we deployed the IVUS, and we can notice here the remnants and the debris along and around the, here the IVUS in the IVC, it's a large vein. And we pull back, we can get the debris and the remnants, and we can calculate very precisely the length we needed for the stent. This is a pre-stenting ballooning. It's a high pressure, short balloon. We do gradual angioplasty by balloon, by different diameter on gradually. This is a short high pressure balloon. And this is after deployment of the stent, and we can notice here there is significant stenotic lesions while the stent is not very well dilated, and we put post-stenting dilatation by this balloon, and this is the completion venography, and we have a very free flow up to the IVC. And this is the completion scan, so we can confirm what we have an outcome and the success of the outcome of the procedure by the IVUS. And by pullback, we can see the stress of the stents. And there is no debris, there is no remnants of the presence of the previous remnant of the post-thrombot. And again, the follow-up of duplex here by B-mode, and this is by dynamic flow, showing a well-deployed with full saturation of the color flow and full patency of the stent. I can say that both cases were performed by Dr. Rashad Beshara, he's the head of our team. And just the last slide for the conclusion, if you allowed me. So to conclude, Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, in venous proximal lesions, IVUS shows high accuracy in morphology diagnosis of iliac venous outflow obstruction, as well invaluable assistance in the accurate placement of the venous stents. And here a kind reminder for our Egyptian Vascular Summit, and I said our because this is the annual meeting of the Vascular Society of Egypt, and this time in collaboration with Alexandria Vascular Conference. It will be in the magnificent city in Alexandria in March 2020. And thank you so much for your attention. Thank you.